Hey guys, thank you so much for joining. My name is Michelle and I want to thank all my new subscribers and for everyone who has been supporting my channel and helping me grow. I really appreciate it. So today's show, I'm going to talk about the first items or the staple items that you should have in your menswear collection if you're a first-time buyer to Louis Vuitton. First things first, don't forget to smash those like and subscribe buttons and leave me a positive comment. They really do help me to grow my channel. Now, my last video was about the first time bags you should buy, and it was geared toward the women's handbags. So I got a request from one of my wonderful viewers, Tim Park, and I was like, oh, that's great, except that women get so confused, where men usually just like, oh, I like it, I don't like it. Does this make my butt look big? Men are so much easier. But that was a great idea because I want to give the rundown of the staple items that every man should buy and what they usually do buy if they're coming into Vuitton for the first time and they're wondering, what should be my first purchase? Now, Louis Vuitton is actually a travel company with handbags, but to women, it's a handbag company. So like I said, if you're shopping as a woman, there are so many hundreds, thousands of options. It's easy to get confused. With men, it's a little more simple. So I'm going to go over the top five products that I think all men should have. But also with Father's Day coming up, these items, they really make an excellent gift if you're thinking about the man in your life, where he should start with some luxury pieces. And also, you know, they're kind of a flex because they're Vuitton, but not too much. They're subtle Vuitton items that any man would appreciate. So item number one is going to be a wallet. Now there's two types of wallets that are bifold, which is, you know, fold in the middle, traditional size wallet, it's about that big. And the two most popular are called the multiple and the slender. So the multiple, like it says, has multiple compartments and it has two compartments for billfold. So if you carry a lot of cash, you wanna carry the multiple. Women happen to like multiples and cash too. Compared to the slender only has one compartment for bills. Hence the name slender. It's more slender than a multiple. I do believe the men's wallets are the most abused product in Vuitton. Men come in with their wallets like stuffed like this and sit on them and do all kinds of crazy things. Watch my video about how not to take care of your Vuitton products and you'll know what I mean. So the wallets get pretty abused. It can be repaired within reason, but it's also easily replaceable. Now, if your man does not carry as much cash or maybe no cash at all, a lot of people don't carry cash anymore, you want to look at the pocket organizer or the card holder, just a very simple card holder. These are great for the men who really don't want to carry a lot of things in their pocket or in their man bag and just might want to keep things simple. Now, all of these items are available in canvas and in the leathers. The most popular canvas prints for men are the Damier Graffite, which is the darker checkerboard collection. It comes in either navy or gray. And you also have the Shadow Monogram, which is black gray, as opposed to the brown. The brown is not as popular in the men's. Some men still want to carry the brown canvas collection, but it's mostly the older generation. I just think the Damier Graffite and the Shadow Monogram just looks so sexy and manly. So I really like those prints. And women also do buy those color prints. You know, we like to say everything in the store is unisex. Also about the wallets, you can hot stamp your initials, and that's a nice little touch. A lot of people don't know that, and it makes such a great gift to show that, hey, I thought about you and I stamped your initials in there as well, up to three. Now, the second most popular item is always the belts. I also did a video about the first time buyers, the teenagers who came in to buy the belt. The most popular belt for men is the LV Initials Reversible. And this is available in different materials. The most popular is the Damier Graffite. It's canvas on one side, leather on the other. This is a great way to convert your belt from like more casual outfits, or if you just, you know, you need to go somewhere where you need to look sleek and wear black, then flip the belt over and you just flip the belt buckle over. Now, one thing to know, the associates that I'm still in touch with asked me to remind you guys, the belts and the buckles are not mix and match. So I remember this, I was like, oh my gosh, thanks for reminding me, because a lot of people would come in and go, well, I want this belt, but I want the gold belt buckle. So could you just take you just switch it, like take that one out of the box and just switch it? And the answer is no, it's not mixy matchy like a candy store. However, there is the option to customize your belt. I forgot what it's called. Pick your belt, My Luli or something, where you can pick your belt and you can pick your belt buckle. Again, the belts are very popular and like, you know, match them with your wallet. It's like a subtle flex. Also popular with the belts is the traditional brown monogram with a gold buckle. It's what we call, don't want to be offended, okay? Don't be offended. It's what we call the drug dealer belt. And it does happen to be popular for both men and women. The belt sizes you will see are in millimeters and centimeters, so no big deal, just ask someone to convert that for you. Just make sure you like measure your waist on the way in. It will make it easier, but you can also try on the belt in the store. Another thing they will not do for you is punch an extra hole. There is no machinery to punch an extra hole. But also, each hole in your belt is actually glazed on the inside if you're purchasing an authentic belt from Vuitton. So you're welcome to go like to a cobbler and punch the hole yourself. Just note that it's not going to be glazed, and that just keeps the integrity of the belt. Number three, backpacks. They are actually pretty popular. It goes in line with the trend of travel for Vuitton. And the most popular backpack is called the Discovery. It's a very simple backpack and it looks great. It comes in the canvas and the leathers. So this Discovery is, it's what I call the never full of the backpacks, because people come in and they want a diaper bag, so I would like a never full. And they'll also go to the men's section and say, I want a diaper bag, so we're gonna look at the Discovery backpack. And hey, what a great way to get your man to carry the diaper bag without looking like a diaper bag. Now keep in mind the Discovery, it's a more casual backpack. It's not really meant for like work and laptops. There are other backpacks for that. The price point, cheapest backpack called the Josh, but this backpack, it's smaller. It kind of looks like a kid's backpack. So, you know, it might work if you have a smaller frame, but for big guys, it's just not the one. Now, the most iconic shape of backpack is the Christopher, but this one I think is a little harder to sell. It is extremely expensive, comes in a lot of different materials. It looks cool, but I would say the opening is not very convenient. Like, it's this large drawstring knapsack type of thing, whereas the Discovery just opens up like this. Make your life easier, you know? So Christopher is more for like the fashion guy and the collectors. Number four on my list, this is an item that is very popular. I thought this would be just a trendy thing, but it still hasn't died down. But I find this item to be so convenient. It's the Avenue Sling Bag. So it's not a backpack, it's not a fanny pack. This is a great man bag or a purse for the man who likes to be on the go, and especially great for traveling. So a lot of men always came in for this. It's available in the Dummy Graphite and also in Infinity Leather. It's really a beautiful bag, and I do suggest the Dummy Graphite. It looks great. What's great about this bag, you can wear on the back, you can also wear it on the front. It lies flat on your chest, so this is a great place to put your wallet and your passport, especially if you're traveling. And it's slim enough that you can wear it underneath your jacket or you can wear it over your jacket. So it's a great idea, especially if you're going to the airport. Everything fits right there, and that way you don't get pickpocketed because the bag is somewhere where you can't see it. Now, the last best gift-giving item and great item to have is a fragrance. I don't know if a lot of people know about Vuitton fragrances. A lot of this stuff is just in my head because I work there. But the fragrances, they start at $265, and it is perfume oil, not cologne. So, you know, it's all relative. It could be a little high for perfume, but then again, some people spend $500 and up on Creed perfumes. Let me show you mine here, because it comes in a cylinder box like this. So that is great for traveling. I just dropped that whole thing in my suitcase. And this is what the bottle looks like. You can engrave initials up to 3, and it's refillable. It looks so beautiful on your bathroom counter or your dresser. So like the spirit of Vuitton, it's supposed to be kept in the family, hence it's refillable. So this particular bottle that I have, that's the amber color, it's from the Oud collection. It's $360. My refill, I believe, is like $260. The other bottles, they start at $265. The refill, I believe, is $165. So it's about $100 off for, you know, the price of the bottle. That's the only way you kind of get some kind of discount at Vuitton. The most commercial and popular scent in the collection is called Limoncité. Limoncité. That would be, how do I say commercial? Kind of like your Calvin Klein-ish scent or like Chanel Blue type of scent. I personally love selling the scent called Orage, which is a blue iris. And also Nouveau Monde was very popular. That's for the earthy, woody tones oud. If you know what oud is, it's that very strong, manly scent. There's also for like the lighter scents, the California collection. That's more of a fun, younger, very breezy type of scent. Most recently, I sampled the newest scent, which is called Meteor. If you need to know any of the scents, you can just look it up on the website and it tells you the description and the keynote. So particularly for Meteor, I looked it up and look at the photo they showed. It's a tangerine with peppers. It's a cutie. It's a spicy cutie. So my next boo is gonna get a spicy cutie from me. So those are my suggestions for top 5 gift giving, or if you're shopping for yourself first time, men's collection in Vuitton. I'm gonna throw in some notable mentions there. I really love the Keepall, and it's extremely popular for both men and women. So the Keepall is just significant, is iconic of Vuitton. Remember, the Speedy is the handbag version of the Keepall. The Keepall comes in size 50, 55, and 60. These are centimeters. The most popular one is 55. Keep this in mind. Someone like me would never carry a 55 because it's huge. So when you're looking at this thing in the store, I suggest you stuff it and think about whether you're really going to carry it. If you're a big guy, like, go for it. But a lot of women shop for this, and I have to like kind of like remind them, are you gonna carry this or is someone gonna carry it for you? Because it can get very awkward and heavy. However, for the guys that carry Keepballs, oh my gosh, looks amazing. Now, I'm a people watcher and I love to travel, so if I'm sitting around in the airport, I'm always looking at people's luggage, and then I want to see who's attached to the luggage. So if I see a handsome looking Keepall, you're always gonna look at who it's attached to. So of course, it's a flex. Another thing to keep in mind is that the Keepall, obviously it's something that you want to use as a carry-on. You don't want to check this thing in. So if you're taking like a road trip, it's great for that. If you're flying like JSX or some kind of private airplane where they'll wrap it in plastic for you, that's great. But if you're flying like Southwest or United, occasionally they will tell you there's no room in the overhead bin. You have to check your bag. It's just screaming, steal me, we're expensive. I must have expensive things inside. I have heard of people's Keepalls or Gucci duffels disappearing, mysteriously disappearing, and there's nothing you can do. So these are things to keep in mind. I mean, I personally would not buy Louis Vuitton luggage for that reason, but you know, everyone has their different reasons. But it is a very handsome, popular, stylish item from the men's department. Now, last thing I want to mention, we did go through like several categories, the SLGs, leather items, travel, and fragrance in the men's categories. Whereas the women's, I only mention handbags. So someone had this question too about shopping different categories, and definitely Vuitton looks at that. If you're trying to get into the VIC list, they will look at that, and it will help your status in the store, and that's when you get invited to stuff. The men's section, it's easy to do that. If you're to this part of the video, don't forget to smash those like and subscribe buttons. As always, leave a positive comment. It really helps me to grow my channel. I welcome all your comments. You guys give me great ideas for future shows. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Michelle. Bye.